Hi, and welcome to Hard Link Migration of User Files and Settings. My name is Kyle Rosenthal. This is a course that's part of the Microsoft Virtual Academy, and in particular part of the course which is migrating from Windows XP to Windows 8.1. Thank you once again for joining us. If you do have any questions at all about the process or that we're discussing or the course, then feel free to send me a tweet using my Twitter handle that's located into there. But for the moment, let's jump in and have a look at USMT, and in particular USMT using hard link migration. So we've already covered across USMT basics in the previous module, and if you haven't listened to that, if you haven't watched that, then make sure you do jump back and have a look at it. So now we're just looking at another version of being able to use USMT. So the main challenge that we have is with USMT is that we need to store everything, so all the user data, which potentially might be a lot, has to be stored somewhere while we're doing a process of it. So rather than having to put that into place, what we want to do is we want to have a look at how we might be able to get around having to do a double up of all of our data, and that's where the hard link migration process on USMT comes in. So we're going to have a look at USMT migration, where it's going to suit, in particular where it's not going to suit, because it's not going to be right for all of your processes, okay? It's only going to be for particular circumstances where this is going to work. But when it does work, it's fantastic, okay? And we'll have a look at sort of how the migration process works as well. So the migration process, just as we've discussed, has two different parts to it. It has scan state to be able to do our capture, and it has load state to be able to push the information back down again. Okay. Now, traditionally, what we do with that is we then have the USMT store be somewhere else. It's either on it's not generally on the local box. It's be stored across onto a network location somewhere. It might be stored on a USB disk that we plug in. And if that's the case, then what we've got to do is we've got to take all the data that we've got on one machine, on the machine, and we've got to copy it into somewhere else. So we need to have this, have the bandwidth and the time and the storage space in order for that to occur. Okay, and what we actually pick up and what we push down, what we copy is going to be controlled by all of our XML files that we've got put into place. Okay, so what we want to try and do is avoid doing that double up if we can. And that's where the hard link migration comes in. So essentially what hard link migration does is it takes advantage of the fact that USMT, the NTFS already does this natively to an extent. Okay. So what we're doing is we're just basically picking up a new, a way to be able to point to a piece of data, or in this case a file or settings, and rather than having that data being copied, we just simply create an additional link to it, okay? And that's where hard link migration comes in. The use case for this, obviously, is that we have to have it on the same machine, okay? It's very good because it means that we're only storing information once. We don't have to make multiple copies. It's all just simply living on the same box on the disk exactly where it was before. We just create a link to it. Okay, so rather than having multiple copies, we've only got it once. So essentially, what happens is that we then have a link to the location on NTFS by creating another pointer to it. So we've got the pointer that we would traditionally see in Windows Explorer or File Explorer. We have a look and we go, okay, well, that's where the file actually exists. We click onto that location and that's where it works. Okay, now, what happens is with USMT, if we do a hard link migration, we create an additional address, if you like, and we'll see this, what looks to be a double up of a file, but in fact, it's actually the same file a little bit later on in the demo. And what happens is when we actually delete the file, what we're deleting is we're not actually deleting the file, but we're deleting the link to that file. So if you were to go through, if you were to run USMT and then start cleaning up, someone's documents folder, what you're actually deleting is the documents folder for what they can see, but not what's actually in the hard link migration store. Okay, until you get to the very last link. the very last link, if you delete that, then that's going to then delete the actual data file. Okay, and of course this is it makes it very fast to be able to put this in a process. And the reason it becomes fast is because we're not doing any copy. We're just simply creating a virtual link as such. So with using hard link migration, and again, like sort of, you know, we're kind of assuming that we have talked about the scan state and load state commands, which is what we've done previously in the previous module, and just simply adding on to that. So the only thing that we need to change within here is we need to change the location. So the location we're actually standing that we're saving our scan state to has to be local. Now, it doesn't have to be called HL store or anything like that. It can be called whatever you want to call it, but it has to be a local. It's local to the disk. Now, the other thing is if we've got multiple disks that we've got, so say for instance, if you have a C and a D drive, then when we go to do the gather of the state and the apply of the state, then that will be reflected, like the CHL store in this case would be a DHL store as well. So in other words, every disk that you run scan state against will have a hard link store for that particular disk. Okay, so we need to make sure that we have an address for that. We also need to make sure that we have the hard link switch in, as well as all the normal sort of information that we'll have as doing our scan state is the command. For our load state command, same. So we need to make sure that we have for that. Essentially, we're just changing it so that we're taking the same command we would run if we were running it to be able to store onto a network location, except that we're not storing onto a network location anymore. We're storing onto a local drive location and using the slash hard link switch. If you do want to get rid of the hard link store to be able to clean it up, then the tool to be able to use that is the usmtutils.exe. It comes as part of USMT. And then we use that to be able to do slash rd to be able to remove the directory, remove the store. And what that does is that removes then the links that are contained within the hard link store. So effectively it does a bit of a cleanup, it cleans up that. So what happens with this when we start to do our deployments? Essentially what it is this, is that we then have a process of having our, we create a link on the disk, which is then our original link, and then we have on top of that the link that we're going to have for our hard link. Now what happens as part of our deployment process is that we'll get rid of the first set of links, but the hard link store will remain, and when we do our load state, we just simply create additional links back again into the operating system, operating system side of things. But the idea is certainly that, you know, it's very quick to be able to put this into place. And just some random numbers that we've got with regards to the sort of processes. Obviously, the more data that you have, the longer it would take if we're doing a file copy environment. And again, you know, these are going to be dependent on what your network locations, what your network locations are, what your speed of connectivity is going to be kind of across into here. But you can certainly see that, regardless, the amount of time that it takes on average for data, if we're doing a hard link migration, we still have to do a scan for it, so we still have to find the data. So therefore, it still takes a period of time. But it's really, basically the same, regardless of how much data we have. But if we have more data, if we're doing a traditional sort of file copy, traditional file copy USMT, then obviously that's going to take longer for that process to occur. So therefore, you know, the more data you have, the more benefit you're going to have from hard link migration. So let's have a look now to see how that looks when it's actually in place. Okay, so let's have a look now to see what that hard link migration looks like in practice. Now what I have is I've got up the command that we ran, it's the same command that we ran for the USMT demonstration, and I'm just going to modify that to then show you how we could turn that into being a USMT hard link migration command. And essentially, it's exactly the same command. So we still need to do all the same sort of things, like using the MIG app, the MIG docs, the config XMLs, etc. The only thing that we need to change is the location of it. So the location, by what I mean by that, is where we're going to store this, because obviously we're not storing it now on a network location, which is what we've got onto here. But instead, it's going to now be into, say, for instance, USMT MIG, and that can really be anything you'd like it to be. And the only other change that we need to make is we need to put onto there that this is now going to be a hard link migration. So using the hard link switch, and then everything else is exactly the same. Remembering that what we will do as well is we're going to put the slash C at the end of that, which will then make it skip over any issues that we might have, so that we don't have any of those non-fatal issues killing off our process. And then we let that run. Now what that will do is that will start the process, and essentially it still does the same scan part that we've done before. What it will do now is, rather than having to copy that anywhere else, of course, what it's doing is it's doing the discovery and just creating the additional links within NTFS. So remember the rules within here, that the hard link migration will only work if we're migrating on the same machine. The other thing that will happen on hard link migration is that we can't have any command that will do a format of the disk, obviously, because that will then, and reconfiguration of the disk in any way, because that would then kill off all the NTFS part of the environment. But this is a lot faster to be able to perform than, say, for instance, it was as doing a traditional USMT, simply because we're not copying the files anywhere else. It's all being completed locally. And obviously, depending on how much data you've got, will depend on how much that will actually take. So as we can see there, it's given us a success that this has actually worked, but it has given us, as expected, the migration error. And we could have a look in the USMT folder that we created, and again, we'd be able to see into there that our scan state text. We have a look in there, what we'll see is the last entry that's in there is that, again, the Windows Defender was running, so therefore that would have caused this an issue otherwise. And if we go back over to here, we can actually see the links now. Essentially, it's the same thing that we would have had, the same files that are looking for the migstate.dat, as well as what's contained within here. Then what we have stored up onto the network, if we were pushing this up to the network, except in this case we're keeping everything local, so it all exists on the local machine. So again, when we went to do our load state would be exactly the same process once we wiped out this, wiped out the operating system and started again. We would then start it with the load state, but point to the hard link using the hard link migration switch. The other thing, and remember, just to sort of to remind you from the last module, that there is the two different versions of USMT that we need to have if we're moving from Windows XP across to Windows 8.1. So we do need to keep that in mind, that we can't use the same version across. Okay, so just wanted to reiterate that, so we made sure that we had that in place. Okay. Okay, so in summary, where are we putting this into place? We're only going to be able to use this if we're going from a machine, a single machine that we're doing our migration from. So in other words, we can't use hard link migration if we move from one physical machine to another physical machine, but we certainly can use hard link migration if it's an in-place migration. So if we're taking one box, turning it from XP into Windows 8.1, that's certainly where we can use hard link migration. Okay, or if we're doing a refresh of an existing operating system on the box, with hard link migration would also be a benefit within there. The benefits of it, main thing is speed, you know, and the fact that, we don't have to copy files from location to location. By keeping it all local, then it, you know, maybe that might also increase our security as well. But certainly it means that, we've got less requirement to be able to have, less time taken to capture and apply the user state as part of our migration process. So some useful links for you. There's a really good article on TechNet about hard link migration that I've got a link from within there. There's another link that I've got for it's Windows XP to Windows 7 hard link migration. There's no updated documentation yet for the Windows XP to Windows 8.1 hard link migration. So that's why I've got the Windows 7 version in there. But the data itself, the methodology is exactly the same. The only thing you have to keep in mind, as we said within USMT within the USMT module, is that we have to be we are going to be using different versions of USMT in order for this to work. So we're going to be using USMT 5 to be able to do the hard link migration within XP, and then to be able to do so the and that's doing the scan state, to be able to do the load state once we get into the Windows 8.1 installation, then we're going to be using USMT 6.3. That's the only wrinkle that's there, but the actual methodology itself is the same across them. So if you need further information, if you want to be able to further involve yourself in the Microsoft world, then on TechNet there are the evals that you can be able to download, and there's evals across all the different products that you can be able to download and test. So if you're wanting to, you know, put into a test environment the details that we talk about within this course, then you certainly can download that from within there, and get up a test environment up and running for free. You also have the IT camps that are running around as well, so make sure that you do see if there's any IT camps that might be suitable for you on any of the topics that we've discussed, or any topic that might be of use for you. And don't forget to check out the rest of the courses that are available on the Microsoft Virtual Academy. Now, obviously, for this particular course, the module that we talked about, that we've looked at now for hard link migration, is just one module within the overall course, but there's also a lot of other courses that you might have interest in as well, to be able to increase your knowledge about working in the Microsoft world. So thank you for your attendance into this module, and we'll see you in the next module in the course. My name is Kyle Rosenthal, and have a great day.